I normally give you a yak before a song, but I'm gonna play two today. And the subject matter's a bit heavy. I don't want to give you the wrong interpretation. I don't know if you can hear the cockatiel. But if you can, there's nothing I can do about it. He's just being a something. Anyway, this first one I'm titled, well, I think after Kubler-Ross's Stages of Grief. It's not about that. It's called Of Death and Dying. And maybe that was some other work she did. Pretty cool though. Done some good stuff. What they don't tell ya is that, like the seasons, those stages aren't something to check off. I'm gonna be angry and then I'm gonna be sad and then I'm gonna accept it. Nah. It's winter today. It was snowing yesterday. And I can stand out there today with no shoes and just a shirt on. And if you know Lithgow, that seems unlikely in winter. But here we are. But I digress. This song's not about that. It's about taking the time to have no time. I don't know. That's why I write songs. You can't listen to me talk. I'm sure some of you can't listen to me sing either. Anyway, and then I'll play a bit more of a cheerier one on this beautiful thing later. Everyone's complaining that they're feeling a little bored. Some of us been quarantined by our minds for years or more. Plenty to do. If you just look inside you, there's more work and playing mental gymnast games than one could ever find the words to say. So here's an easy one. It's as simple as they come, and the only one we really know for sure will have a day prep was worth the chore. Have you practiced dying? The act of nothingness. It ain't worth getting worked up about. It'll be the very best. It's the one thing that you can have faith in. It's the one sure gambler's margin that guarantees a win. It's not that bad at all. Like having a peaceful sleep. I'm not suggesting for one second that you go and run a race or up the street. It's like a cuddle. Open your heart and shut your brain. Just watch it all go by, every thought and every pain. And out there's this blue skies beyond the clouds. It's always there when you need it. It will never let you down. And now there's here, even under the blackened night. The buses that we float in, shared by infinite specks of light. So there's a simple one, it's as easy as they come. And the only one we really know for sure will have a day when the play receives applause. So practice. dying. And embrace the nothingness. Get your mind out of the gutter into the coffin of eternal rest. Have faith, my friends. You're heading that way fast. You'll nail it easy peasy, like laughing or allowing a fart. Yes, practice nothing. Just rest within yourself. Your spirit knows the right way home. Let it lift you out of hell. We're all bound for greatness. We're all in debt to death. We're all due the same sameness. We're all running out. Breath. We're all dying, so shout hip hip hooray. We're all headed home, we're all off to the same grave. Yes, we're all dying, so shout hip hip hooray. We're all headed home, we're all off to the same grave. The other side of that coin is not my specialty. So how does one practice being done? It's not very comfortable to think about. But neither's having a poo in the bush. But it's got to be done. Now I reckon, and it's only a reckon, that if you give yourself a bit of a time out, put your ass on the grass, birds, not through this, like, yeah, that is a nice kookaburra. Just with them, they're fine, they do the exact job that we're after here. You just sit there and look around and you smell and, you know, maybe. If you're like me, you see a bee next to you, panic for a moment that it's going to stab you and you're both going to die right there, or just go, oh, there's a bee, that's good, we need them. Maybe admire the glint of the gum leaves in the sun, admire how on the other side they're not really darker, they've got that nice translucent green thing going on. And some of them are still, even though it's breezy. It's interesting to me, not probably interesting to a lot of other people. You know, maybe look at the flies all gathering with their shimmering backs and their many eyes, that purple tinge they get through their wings as they mount a dog nugget. It's the circle of life. It's good to appreciate being in a circle. Costs you nothing, feels like nothing else. Anyway, that's enough preaching. This one's called The Sitting Fire. First thing in the morning, and even though I'm getting out of bed at 4:30, I'm already done. I'm thinking about you, old friends. Chances are I'll never see you again. If the plague don't claim ya, then living surely will. And if it's neither, there's every chance that I'll be killed. But sitting in my belly while the walls are coming down gives me freedom to feel the fires of this world. See, sitting in your belly while the sky's falling down gives you freedom. I can't remember the last time I roared while feeling so low. I forgot that it rids the need for a punchline to life's cold jokes. See, sitting in your belly while the walls are coming down gives you freedom to feel the fires of this fucked up fucking world. Sitting in your belly and you'll find and you're found. Yeah, sitting in your belly, that's freedom. Chances are we may never meet again. But sitting in our bellies while the world's falling down gives us freedom to feel the fire of this world. See, sitting in our bellies is where love is found. Yeah, sitting in our belly, that's freedom. It always feels the same to sit in fire, sit in freedom. What good a way to paint your belly on fire, that's freedom. Tough, and some of you are doing a lot tougher than others. I hope you can find your own peace. In whatever way you do. Because ain't nobody or no thing ever gonna do that for you. Much love. Sure.